Tim Bradley versus Juan Manuel Marquez, the biggest thing in Vegas right now. It's on HBO pay-per-view Saturday night. Let's introduce yourselves real quick.
Norm Fraunheim with Ring and 15 Rounds.
Ryan Macaniano with Boxing Scene and Comcast Sportsman.
So Norm, Ryan, how do you guys break down this fight, Bradley Marquez?
Well, I see Bradley not engaging, being tactical, clever. I'm sure that he's watched what happened to Pacquiao, and he's not going to make that same mistake. And if you remember, Pacquiao was well on his way to a victory until he ran into that right hand, Bradley's smart enough not to repeat that mistake.
I think this is close to a pick-em 50-50 fight as we've seen as far as high-profile fights go in a long time.
Gennady Golovkin just said that.
Yeah, and you know, I think the questions I think are more so with Bradley than with Marquez. You know, a lot of people forget that when Marquez coming off that amazing knockout of Pacquiao, but before that, he was taken the distance by Fedchenko. I think he's the type of fighter who takes what's given to him and goes for it. I don't see him being, you know, really pushing the issue unless Bradley turns into a war. And then on Bradley's end, we don't know which one Bradley's going to show up, especially because that last fight he had with Brodnikov, I mean, he was slurring his words. I interviewed him about a month after that Brodnikov fight, and he was still slurring his words. I mean, he seems okay now, but we don't know which one Bradley's going to show up. I do think, though, that it would be unwise for him to stand and trade with Marquez. I think we'll see him stay outside, like Norm said, be very tactical and maybe use a couple of those veteran tricks. Maybe use his head.
It could be a controversial end. There could be a headbutt. I do think it could be a split decision. In fact, that's how I'm picking for Bradley. It goes without saying, the split decision is controversial.
You know why I love boxing? Because you just said something random, like, I made head in a headbutt. Imagine it ends in a headbutt, and people go back to this video and say, man, this guy knows who's boxing.
No.
Anything's possible. Yeah. My last question, the winner of this fight, Bradley Marquez, does he fight the winner of Real Pacquiao?
Marquez, yeah, I think so. I don't believe what he's telling us about that book is closed. I think that he'll go back to Mexico. He'll be the second greatest fighter in Mexican history, and then he'll say, "Well, I had to change my mind because the Mexican nation is demanding that I do this." Bradley, I'm not so sure because he stated pretty clearly that he didn't want to go to China, and I don't know where else he would get the fight.
I see Rios winning that fight. So,
well, there you go. Okay.
So that changes that. What do you say, Ron?
Well, I wonder if Marquez were to win, I see all roads leading to Pacquiao again for a fifth fight. Marquez now knows he can go in there and hurt Pacquiao and knock him out, so he'd be on the confidence high, especially coming off the Bradley win, if he were to beat Tim. And then again, obviously the money. They'd have to make the money right, I think. Back then when he was making $5 million while Pacquiao was pulling 25, he's definitely going to have more bargaining chips at the table. And then, on Bradley's end, I don't know if he takes this fight. Of course it's the biggest fight if he stays and keeps it in-house in the top rank. It's the biggest money fight he can make. But as you said, Ali, we don't know if Manny's going to make it past November 23. Right. I mean, I think the best example, my concern for Pacquiao is what happened to Roy Jones after he got knocked out by Tarver. They sent him right to Glenn Johnson. He thought he was going to run Glenn Johnson over, and he ate it.
All jokes aside, very few fighters in the history of boxing from such a devastated knockout, you could count them who's ever come back from that.
Right.
I know about people who were knocked out, not stopped or controversial.
Right.
So we'll see. Very interesting fight November 24th and very interesting fight here October 12th. Last thing, people want to follow you guys on Twitter?
They can follow me on 15 Rounds, but Twitter for me is digital graffiti. I apologize to all those who have those accounts.
My Twitter account is RMAQ28.
There you have it, Stephen. Thank you so much, gentlemen, and we'll see you tomorrow night. Who wins? FiercerReporting.com. I'm Melissa, back reporting.